My name is Julian Gallant. I am director of Pushkin House. I run this house in Bloomsbury, and I run its cultural program as well. So this is a lot of activity based here. It's all Russia related or close to Russia related, and some of it has no relation at all to Russia, a small part. But we have book launches, we have lectures, we have exhibitions, as you see tonight. We have concerts, we have plays, and we teach Russian. So we have teach Russian to about 400 people around London. Some of them come here, we go out to some of them, but there's a lot of interest. So it's a busy, busy place.
So how many exhibitions do you launch a year?
Exhibitions about 10 a year. We like to have an exhibition for 3 to 4 weeks. We think that's about the right time. And we try to encourage as much variety as possible. I must say that I can't say that we have the works of Viktor Pivovarov every day at every exhibition. Of course we don't. And in fact, this exhibition is a great advance for us. It's the work of a great artist, a famous artist, somebody who's seen in all the galleries of the world, all the museums of the world. He's a very, very well-known name, very, very natural person, but very well-known name. He himself said he thought this was the right place to exhibit these drawings, and I agree with him, because it's a place where you can get close to them, you can be intimate with them, you can talk to your friends about them, you don't feel you're in the formal confines of a huge gallery space, you're right up close to them as if they were in your own home, and that's the kind of atmosphere we like to create.
Are these exhibitions popular with your students? And this place was packed out today, yeah. It was full of people.
Lots of people came. There's a natural interest in Viktor Pivovarov, but all our exhibitions are popular. They attract a lot of different kinds of people, particularly tonight though, extraordinary. There were Russians, there were non-Russians, some old people, some young people, there were mothers and daughters, there were fathers and sons. Basically the whole range of people who come to Pushkin House events were seen here tonight, so I'm very, very happy about that.
What is it the students find in these pictures in the exhibitions? What does it sort of give them?
Pivovarov. I think Pivovarov, there's a special character about Pivovarov, and of course it's not to be spoken about in one word. It's not fair to sum up in one word the works of an artist. And by the way, I am my background as a musician is not as an artist, so I can't give you any of the jargon and all the technical vocabulary about it. But if I had to sum up these pictures and their effect, it's a process. It's a great. There's a mystery in them, but it's a mystery through an incredible naturalness. Viktor himself thinks that some of them are rather difficult to understand. There's things in them, there's elements in them which you can see, elements of familiarity, things that draw you in. And when you start looking at them, then you see the complexities and you see the depth of thinking behind it, and then you see the mystery. So it's a process of through very, very natural, natural objects, symbols, if you like. You see something which you really could look at forever and not completely understand.
So
I love that in art.
Understanding art, is it a good facilitating process for the students to actually acquire the language? Is there some kind of open to the culture of the language?
I'm going to revert to music for a little bit for the analogy you're talking about, because we're talking about analysis here. We're talking about taking it apart. We're talking about looking at it, describing it, and looking at what's there, taking it down to its components. In music, there is no piece of great music in the world that suffers from analysis. So if you take a great piece of music, you pull it apart, you see what's going on inside it, you see how the composer wrote it, it's still a great piece of music, and it will probably be a greater piece of music for you than before you started that process. I believe the same is true about art. I believe that someone as great an artist as Pivovarov, if you take his work apart, if you study it, if you look at it, and you look right into it, you will begin to see its deeper mysteries. And in fact, the things that attracted you at first will still be there, but you'll start to see the other things as well. And that is what is interesting about such an artist.
Great, thanks very much.